Hello and welcome back. We're going to continue with Dark Souls. So we're going to check out the other part of the forest down here. He got the special ring. You should check out what that ring does too, by the way.
Oh, yes.
So you have ring slots. And you Wolf Ring. Boost Poise. Which is the stat you need to not be knocked out of defense
as easily. Oh, okay. That's nice.
Yeah, or knocked out of your own attacks and stuff.
Unmatched with a greatsword. Okay, interesting.
Yeah. It's actually super useful, especially if you're going with a heavy build.
Yep.
So.
Down we go.
Oh, sorry. Excuse me.
He just died a little.
A little bit. My left lung, it stopped working.
Oh, shit! Let go! What in the hell?
Yeah, don't let them. That little
Fuck
thing
you.
Where they raise their arms up like they're praying to Jesus and then come down.
Damn.
That's that move. I'm surprised it took that long for you to actually get affected by that. I thought you were going to get caught by it earlier because I saw it like two or three times and I was like, he has no idea what that does. I'm not going to say anything. Yeah, that grab move is bullshit. That literally, when I walked in here the first time in my first playthrough,
mm-hmm.
I walked in. And straight up, I saw that enemy, and I went up to him because no other enemy had tried to grab me like that in the game yet.
Yep.
And the first thing he did was that grab move and killed me. And I went, are you fucking kidding me right now? What is this bullshit? Like, I couldn't believe it. I was like, are you serious? And so I was way more intimidated just going into this area than I needed to be.
Oh, yeah. Because the dang thing nearly kills you.
Yeah.
Now,
it straight actually killed me.
Oh,
I didn't
God.
Have enough health at the time.
Okay, so it does let go after like a set time. It's not...
Yeah, it does a certain number of hits of a predefined amount of damage.
Okay.
And so if you have low health and it manages to grab you, you're just screwed. And in that playthrough, my very first playthrough, I was going pure dex and nothing else, and I didn't know how to split up or what my split should be on my stats and stuff.
Okay.
And so I was literally all dex, and I hadn't put a single point into anything other than dex and endurance.
Okay.
Because I was like, I'll just do fury of blows. I'll attack like 4 million times, and that's what I'll do. And it was like, so I didn't put anything into like the health stat.
Whoops.
And so I got really good at dodging.
Yeah, I'll bet.
But I just didn't expect it. That other thing is down there.
What's that?
Yep. But yeah, I was just like, what? Oh, there's a big guy. To your right a little bit, he's laying on the ground.
Okay, it's one of those guys. All right. Nope, there he is. He's getting up now.
I love you. I love you. I must tell you I love you.
Fuck you. No, keep going. No, stop that. That's not okay. Fuck you. Shit.
Nope. Ugh.
Oh, God. Oh. Okay. Careful. We can talk about this.
Careful when you go to heal, because he has a charge move.
Yeah.
Okay, you should be fine. Just be careful where you back into.
Yeah.
That's always the other big problem with the big guys, is they'll, like, zone you a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And try and push you to places you may not want to go. Nice dodge.
Nope, you're dead first.
They got cool armor, though.
Yeah.
Those guys look really cool. Their helmets always make me think of, like, Legend of Zelda and stuff.
Yeah. I see an item back there.
Yarp. Oh, look off to your right.
Yep. He was floating a little bit.
Don't worry about that. Sometimes you just gotta float. Oh. You've never floated when you slept?
God damn it. I did not dodge it.
Oh.
That's a tree.
He doesn't care. He is also known as the feller of trees.
He's doing a shitty job of that.
Oh, God.
Okay, never mind, actually. Here.
I'm going to be honest. Your best bet is to stay right up next to him and then strafe to his right.
Okay.
You want a clear area where you can just strafe around him if you can pull him out to one.
Yeah.
But, because fighting in these trees is what makes this fight hard, because it's not easy to maneuver.
Yeah.
So, like, over towards that flower would be a good area, because he might get stuck. And you could just
like that?
Maybe run up and take some free shots at him while he's stuck between the trees, because trees are hard. You have to hold down Y?
Why?
Hold it. You have to hold it down.
Oh,
yeah, you might not have to. You might not be. I don't think you can have it in your offhand in this game. I forget about that all the time.
Yeah.
You can in the other ones, because what they do is when you press Y in the other games, it'll two-hand your main weapon, and if you hold it, it'll two-hand your off weapon.
Mm-hmm.
So, crossbows are just flat damage. They will not scale.
And they don't seem to aim either.
They can. Click R3. I think. Click L3. Or maybe you can't this one. You can in the other ones. You can aim the bows, though.
Yeah.
But bows also scale with your dex. They'd be a better choice for you, honestly, since you're already doing dex.
Yeah.
That will do almost no damage to him, to be fair. Because of his 10. Armor.
Except when he actually, like, blocks. He doesn't understand trees, he understands...
If you just stay so that he gets stuck in those trees instead of going that way... Oh, now you let him free.
Kind of. Still.
It depends on how exploitative you want to be. He must think he has just enough room for some of that, but he doesn't.
Okay, he's stuck. So go to the right.
Well, no, when you're actually fighting him. Because when he swings, if you go to the right and you're constantly just strafing to the right to get behind him, his swing, see that swing? See how it works? You have all that free room underneath the right-hand side.
Fuck you.
It won't work right now because you're not really fighting him in an open area where you can strafe to get the effect I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Right now, it's just if you bait out an attack and back up, you can just let him wear himself out and then take free shots on him.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's stuck.
Poke.
Ooh, he caught you a little bit.
Yeah.
Fortunately, you have so many Estus. There you go. But when he's out in an open area, strafing to the right is basically his Achilles heel.
Okay.
If you stay really close and strafe to the right, he will miss you.
Why?
There's two of them, by the way.
Why?
And a bunch of tree guys.
Jesus.
Did you think it was going to be that easy?
And I already fought like...
Now oh you're God, caught
now
in the
I'm
trees.
I'm caught in the stupid trees.
Not just for the bad guys.
One.
These guys aren't really the problem necessarily. He is.
Mm-hmm.
Good dodge, though.
I think he just... Oh, no. No, none of that. Please, no.
That's not a good place to go. That's not a good place to go.
That's the poison thing.
Yep, and there's no maneuver space over there either. Yep.
Fuck. Why? I couldn't block or move.
That item is optional. Well, you couldn't dodge because he cast this stupid AoE thing.
Yeah, but the block was the...
Yeah. You probably didn't have enough left after trying... Because it still consumes, when you're like that, it still consumes the stamina as though you tried to dodge.
Well, I dodged just second.
Yeah. I'm just saying, that's why you're probably low on stamina in the first place. So. But that's an optional item if you want it. It's just it drops those four guys and then two of those guys, and you have to deal with them.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't have to go for it now. Oh, everyone decided to come down this time.
It's a party.
Hello, tree party. You make vegans proud.
Mm-hmm.
So, there's four of them. Moral ethical dilemma. Oh, you're dead.
Damn.
Yep. Jeez. At least you got your souls.
Yeah.
Moral ethical dilemma question about these guys.
Okay.
So, you're a vegan. You won't eat meat, right? It has to be, you know, whatever. It has to be plants.
Mm-hmm.
What if the plants were like this? Because those are just plants. They aren't anything else. They're just like plant monsters.
Yeah.
Technically, they're just plants. Can you eat them as a vegan?
Well, I suppose it would depend on what you define as vegan. Is it the fact that it is able to move around? Is it a ability to react or scream, or is it
intelligence? Okay. How about instead, easier question. What if you're a vegetarian?
Vegetarian would be, I suppose that would be the same problem, really.
Because, like, vegans have, like, weird levels, you know? Like,
yeah, because there's, like...
Like how my girlfriend always says, you know, I'm a level 5 vegan, which means I don't eat anything that casts a shadow. You know, like, she isn't, but that's a joke she heard once. And it's like, so they have these weird levels. It's like, I'm just like your standard vegan, which is basically a vegetarian. And there's one that's like, I'm ovo-lacto-vegetarian or whatever. And it's like, oh my God, what the hell does that even mean?
Well, I know there's like, I read somewhere that it's like, is honey okay for vegans to eat?
Why wouldn't it be?
Because it is produced by an animal. Never mind the fact that...
It's their puke.
Yeah, but some vegans won't eat anything produced by an animal.
Sorry to anyone who we just ruined honey for, by the way.
Yeah, well...
If you really want that item, you could just run in there and grab it and run back out.
I mean,
and you might die, but you'll have the item.
I suppose I've died enough.
I would just try and get away so that it's easier to get your souls back.
Jump! Run away! Oh God, I've pissed everything off.
Yep, that's how it works.
But, I'm probably gonna die here anyway, so whatever. Ow.
I'm prepared to die! Sacrifice me on the altar of Cthulhu-chan! Oh.
Take me, I'm yours!
That's how I feel about Bloodborne sometimes. When I know I'm gonna die, it's like, okay, sacrifice me to Cthulhu, I get it.
Yeah. But anyway, with the honey thing, it's like, the issue I have with that is, basically, farmers couldn't produce any of the, like, fruits and vegetables without employing, like, without using bees to pollinate them.
Yeah.
Like, it's actually a major thing that is keeping that is helping the bee population.
Yeah.
But then those plants that they're farming for are just as much a product of those bees as their honey. Because they produce such an excessive amount of honey.
Go that way.
I knew I was
the going. Area you're trying to go to, you don't need to go anymore. You got the item. The ambush is useless now.
Yeah.
Ooh. And both of them were like, we're going to touch you. We're going to touch you where you don't want to be touched.
There's going to be another one behind me. Just know it.
What one thing I do like about this area is that the enemies make noise. Like, their footsteps make noise.
Yeah.
And so, like, they make this really quiet, just ambient noise so that maybe you'll hear it, you know?
Yeah.
So you got that one to your right. So you can try it on this guy. So get right up to him and go to the right. And just keep circle strafing. You'll get behind him. And then anytime he turns around, just go to the right of him and stay next to him.
Too bad I can't backstab him.
It's going to be hard when you're like this, though, so. You might want to wait for this to wear off. Because without the speed that you normally get, there you go.
There we go.
See?
Yeah. Poke.
Wasted.
Oh, no. Poke.
Oofta. Good thing you invested in endurance.
Yep.
There you go. Yeah, right. Their big weakness is just go to the right. It's really funny. Because they want them to be intimidating, because then it doesn't make you think maybe I should be up next to this guy.
Yep.
Nighthelm.
Oh, yeah, that's the nice knight armor.
Yep.
But it's heavy.
Right. That's a nice upgrade.
Yep. Yeah, the thing you got is special. That actually requires special materials to upgrade, too. You just have to remember that the knight armor is actually kind of heavy.
Yeah.
So, like, go over one to your status thing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so now you're above half, so you're going to have a slower roll because of it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Yeah, see, now you got the semi-fat guy roll. That's actually not the worst roll, either. There's another one of those poison guys. You don't have to fight him. He doesn't have anything important.
Yeah, I'm going to skip that.
What you could do is maybe change the leggings out. Hello.
I'm going to give this a quick try, just because, like, I've got the super heavy shield, and he's apparently really no. God damn. Fuck you.
But even your moving speed is slowed, so now you're, like, super slow.
Mm-hmm.
I see that slight right, and he totally missed you on that third swing.
Mm-hmm.
It's taking very little of my stamina compared to before to block his shots, so.
Yeah.
Which, notice I'm quicker with the shield than a dodge.
Oh, so he dropped something. Ah, he dropped his shield. That's actually a rare drop. That thing is ridiculously heavy.
Jesus.
Yeah. That thing's super crazy heavy. It's not terrible, but it's hella heavy.
Yeah.
Sorcery ahead.
Oh good. Caster ahead.
They're not wrong.
So let me guess, now that I've got this super nice but heavy armor, it's not gonna help me against the next enemy I fight.
Yes. you can look off to the right.
See
this walkway?
Oh, another bridge fight. That's good.
Sure.
All right, let's. All right, which of these was the heavy? Just strip naked. Yep.
Hit X to go toggle the display of them.
Yeah.
Yeah. So equip the leather armor.
That provides a lot.
And then, so the thing is that, now look at what it does give you versus that.
It's making specifically my magic defense worse.
And yeah, lightning. Your magic and lightning defense. Your fire's slightly better in it, but not by much.
So for this fight, in particular, my old stuff is significantly better.
Yes. You also may want to look at your shield.
Oh, because that... Okay, shield my...
This shield is meant for physical, right?
Yeah.
But look at its magic defense.
30. Oh, jeez.
But the thing is that is super heavy.
Yeah.
And it's likely, because look at your regular shield's weight.
Yeah, it's going up by
like 15. check some of the other ones. Like, that's 35, that's 40. Now, there's a shield you can get later that's really good. This fight, technically speaking, you can do, or you can skip it.
Okay.
For now. Because what it gets you is...
Holy crap.
Key item for later.
Okay, never mind that. Oh, shit. Alright. Equipped just for this fight. Whole new set of armor, minus the helmet.
Yep. You can get a key item for later if you wanted to.
Do I have a mustache?
Sure. No, it's just because you're hollow.
Yeah.
And the thing has, like, a beak on it on the front, on the bottom part of it. Nope. The camera center just above your head.
Oh, goddamn. All right.
Have fun with this.
Because I don't know if I'll actually even have time to use one. Oh, what nice music.
Look up and around and target.
Oh, fuck. Oh, interesting.
Yeah, this boss is really cool looking, and it's a lot different than any of the other bosses in the game.
Yeah. Am I in a bullet hell?
Good for you.
How am I?
Oh God. Good is... for you too. Fuck off.
Yeah.
Give me something useful.
That's one thing that I liked about the later ones, where they didn't let any of the messages show up in the boss rooms until after.
Yeah. Like, a bit of help would be nice, but just, I did it. Thanks, dick.
Yeah, because everyone would always do that, they turned them off until you beat the boss in the later ones.
Jesus. Okay, so I can do that. Can I just leave?
Nope.
How the fuck do I reach him?
You don't. Son of a... You survive. This boss is a ridiculous boss.
Oh, hey, it's... No.
There's a shield we can try and go for that will be even better. Oh, see? It lands.
Oh.
You gotta stay near it, because it lands is the thing.
Okay.
That's your opportunity to attack, but you only have so much time.
It doesn't stay locked. Damn. It's gonna hit me, isn't it?
Yes. It will stay locked, but you gotta stay close enough.
Well, no, like, I couldn't lock on when it was landed. Yeah.
But if you're locked on initially when it's landing, it will stay locked on.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
it's because its lock-on point goes below the border, so it thinks you can't see it.
Okay. It's a little bit of a design failure.
Yeah. Well, it was also early 360, so I'm not surprised.
Oh, I suppose, yeah.
So.
Alright. It's amazing just how... Well, that freaked out a bit.
Yeah. Yeah, some of its parts are physics-based and others aren't.
Yeah. It's amazing. Just, like...
This thing looks really cool, though.
Oh, yeah. Like, yeah. It's amazing how much game design has just improved, even just... Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Like, just since that time.
Mm-hmm. This boss fight is so weird, because it's so slow.
Mm-hmm.
You know? It's so different than every other boss fight where it's like, there he's coming down. Since you're melee, these are your only chances here, and I want to make use of them. As soon as it starts coming down towards your level, you know it's landing. If it goes up, it's just going over.
Okay. Get away from the exploding thing. I mean, I can go just like...
Yeah. Hey. The problem is that without your shield up...
Get drunk.
You're doing a lot better than the first time than I thought you would. Mm-hmm. I honestly thought you would just get biffed right away. Because that happens to a lot of people with this fight.
Yeah. Oh, and he used that as a shield. Okay.
Yeah, but not the fog part.
Oh, good to know.
It will shoot through the fog part. Only the solid parts.
I'm weirdly good at dodging, like, tracking projectiles like that.
Seems like it, because I'm like, man, you're getting real lucky on this, on some of these.
Okay, I need to fake that one out. No, not what I...
Oh, it's coming down! Man, if you beat this on the first shot, I'm gonna laugh, because...
It's at half health and I'm down to 3 flasks, so unless I improve, I'm not in good shape.
Yeah. This is why getting the magic shield that has like a 90% magic reduction is usually what people will try and do before they do this fight.
Ah.
But it's...
Bloodstain, good.
It's annoying. Though it holds an ember that's really helpful.
Freak out tail.
Yeah. Because you can't aim, you can't lead shots with this thing either, which is another big annoyance.
Yeah. Uh-huh, fuck you. Back over it goes. About there? Yep.
Ooh, nice. Nice. She just wants to touch you with a little bit of her magic.
Mm-hmm.
Seems like she's switching to an alternate pattern. And
nice. And you even switched to two-handed.
Mm-hmm. Thought about a shitty way to die. Fail a dodge.
Yeah. Didn't. I didn't leave.
I fucked up a dodge and.
Ooh. Oofed. God, I always think that's gonna hit you.
Yeah, like that one in particular. I'm like, oh god, I biffed the dodge. Uh-oh. Oh, this is new.
That's new.
Ow.
And painful.
Don't do it again.
please don't do it again.
All right, I'm out of ammo for that, so.
Oofed. You are randomly good at that, at dodging that thing.
Oh, shit. That's much harder.
Come on down. Oh, I just gotta survive long enough. Come on down. Nope, it's gonna do the thing, the bubble thing. Whoa, where did that... Okay, bye, I guess. There was somebody over there she wanted to kill, I guess.
Okay with that.
Yeah. Come on down, come on down. Come on down to the Price is Right. Yes, yes!
Yes. Alright, no, that... Pop. Fuck you.
Yeah! Oh my god, first try on the Moonlight Butterfly without any help. Okay then, well, that was a thing, damn.
Alright.
Good job. Very nice. So that's your first real, or second, boss soul. That one can make some really cool stuff, including the Moonlight Greatsword, which is a thing in all of their games, since one of their older Dark Souls predecessor games.
Demon Souls?
No, even before that.
Huh.
Praise the... Yeah.
Fuck you, too.
So, you can make that thing, which is really cool, magic-based greatsword.
Okay.
Which is interesting.
Still strength, though?
Mainly strength, but you do need magic to use it.
Okay.
Because it has special abilities on its two-handed power attacks.
Okay.
But, I'm
thinking, like, there should be a doorway partway up this.
Oh... Yeah, no. I don't think there is.
A long, epic stairway.
Yep.
With a trap behind me.
Yeah, with a mimic. Oh. Mm-hmm. So then you get up to this. Armor strewn all over the place. Great knight shields.
Weird ghost thing.
And what appears to be a blacksmith holding something. A dead, petrified blacksmith.
Pillage corpse.
Watch our base, McKee.
Continue pillaging corpse.
Divine Ember.
Homeward
Bone.
Okay.
So that's so you can jump back to the bonfire without having to go past the whole area again. That's why they give you a Homeward Bone.
Okay.
So you can just go back to the bonfire for free.
Alright. Worth doing, you think?
Yeah.
I am out of Estus Flasks.
Usually after that fight, yeah.
Reduces poison and toxin. It restores status. Okay. And... Yep. Sorry, I hadn't looked at those before. Alright.
So, the Divine Ember lets you upgrade +5 weapons. You can then instead go to the modify equipment thing.
Okay.
And you can change them to different types. So now you'll want to go back to the blacksmith.
Oh, so I will still...
You'll need him to do weapon elemental upgrades.
Okay.
To switch something from like regular to divine. You know, or regular to lightning or whatever.
Okay.
Or
is it totally feasible that I just have this spear through my whole playthrough?
Yes.
Okay.
That's the thing about this game, is that depending on what your upgrade path for your weapon is, having a second partisan isn't necessarily a bad idea, because you could have one that's just upgraded to +15 regular, and then another one that is, like, upgraded to, you know, +5, and then you switched it to holy... For certain situations.
Okay.
Because certain elements are really helpful in certain areas or against certain types of enemies.
Bye. Okay.
So, but yes, it is totally feasible. Like my game, I had my regular scimitar in my first game all the way to the end.
Try kicking.
The only thing I did is I got it to +10 and then I switched it because I realized I could, or +8, some weird number like that. I infused a boss soul into it from one of the mid-level bosses and turned it into a magical scimitar thing.
Okay.
So that's back towards the blacksmith. This is an alternate path.
Okay. Anything interesting up here or not?
There is, but that area is that area leads to you know where you fought Havel?
Okay.
It connects to that. It's a shortcut over to there.
Oh, okay.
The key you got, I believe, lets you in there, the Watchtower basement key. So it creates a shortcut between the Undead Burg and that area.
Okay.
The only other problem with that is that the rest of that area down there, other than going through there, is way too high a level for you right now.
Okay.
It's called the Darkroot Basin, and there's some angry shit down there.
Okay. Sneaky, nope.
You thought you could sneak past the guy with no head? I mean, theoretically. Doing more damage. No, I like your tail.
I do. It's helping me stay behind him.
Yeah, I know, right? And as long as you're not on that left-hand side, it tends not to hit you when it does stuff. That's the thing you gotta be worried about. This might take a little while.
Oh! Now. No.
Hold on, stay still. No. I don't wanna.
Oof-ta. That was a little close.
Yeah. So once it fires, the angle stays constant. It won't turn.
Yep.
It just goes straight. But it has a late fire to it.
Okay. Holy shit. Oh, right, I've got the... I'd like to switch my equipment right now. Let's go.
Yeah? Well, you won't come out here, so screw you.
Screw you, I'm doing things. Leave me alone.
I know. Maybe putting on the main part, but leaving that, yeah. Because you have to build up. This is the other reason why you invest in endurance, is if you want to wear any of the heavier armors, you really got to invest it, otherwise you're stuck in the light armors.
Okay.
I actually appreciate that, unlike most games where it's like, oh, it doesn't really matter what kind of armor you equip, because, you know? Yeah. Like, there's not any real good penalty for why you would pick one over the other.
Yep. Oh, God, even just...
Yeah, that stuff's super heavy.
Well, like, those add... That's not even a full pound. Oh, it's because I went there. I could probably wear the gauntlets.
Yeah. Yeah, I can. Your helm is also super heavy, too.
Yeah, that's not helping. He healed, didn't he?
No. They'll only heal once he goes to... Once you go to the bonfire.
Okay.
Boop. Or if somebody had a spell or something that he was casting.
Shit.
No, I will live in your chest. It's safe here.
Damn it. Out. Ooh. I know there's a bonfire like 3 feet away, so that's why I'm just like, I can chug Estus Flask for a while. God damn.
Yeah, he doesn't like when you're behind him, so he likes to jump out of the way.
Yeah. I like being behind him.
I know. That's how I feel about most enemies in this game, I'm gonna be honest. Being behind them is usually the much safer option.
Damn it! No, I just wanna...
It's like, look, I know you don't like me being back here, but I do. And
That's
a maneuver I have not seen. I don't think I've seen him do that before.
Well, all right then.
Come here!
Jeez.
All right, well, we will pick this up in the next episode. Thank you all so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next episode of Dark Souls. Bye.
Bye.